Imagine for today's video your own virtual room. Because it's virtual, it can look however you want, with a big window bringing in lots of light, a picture of you and your parents, a nice, big, comfy and cozy bed with a warm, snuggly blanket and a soft pillow, a bookshelf for all your books, and a drawer for your clothes with a nice lamp on top of it. Then you would also need a nice box for your toys, to help keep your room look tidy and nice. But does it really look like this all the time? No. Usually there are lots of toys lying around on the floor and on your bed, clothes lying around everywhere, even in the most unexpected places, and maybe some books left there where you last opened them. And that's fine, because the bot we will develop today will tidy up your virtual room for you. Okay, so let's start building the bot that will tidy up our virtual rooms. I've already done some initializations here, just to save time. I will just explain them and then we will go on building the bot. So we have here first an assign where we assign to a list of objects an expression, and that expression is the following. We basically initialize our list of objects lying around in the room that we have to tidy up. And we would take these objects in this list and we will slot them to the right lists, trying to categorize them and put them in the right place. And the way we define a list and we initialize it in the same instruction is we say new list and then the type. In this case, we will have string because we just have some names of objects. And then to initialize it as well, we have new string again, and then in curly brackets we have all the elements in the list. We have socks, ball, train, doll, star, pants, the hobbit and Winnetou, and we will have to take each of these elements and slot them to the right list or the right category. And how do we do that? We need to know what are these categories. And these categories we maintain in a dictionary. And this is where we initialize a dictionary. We want to have three categories. One would be the clothes drawer, one would be the bookshelf, and one the toys box. Now this is just a comment here. I did it by right-clicking and clicking annotations. But we assign to this dictionary of categories, and here is the variable. It is of type dictionary of string and string. So the key is a string and the value is a string as well. The rest are lists of string. And here in the expression, we have quite similar to the way we define the list. We have new dictionary of string and string because we have the key and the value. And then we have from and we have curly brackets. And then in pairs, between curly brackets and commas, the object and the category. And we have socks, which should go in the clothes drawer, ball should go in the toys box, train, toys box, doll, toys box, the star as well, the pants should go in the clothes drawer, and then the hobbit and Winnetou should go in the bookshelf. So this dictionary of categories, this is how we tell the bot where these objects should go. And then we define three empty lists, just new list of string. We have a list for the clothes drawer, a list for the bookshelf, and a list for the toys box. And now we have to basically go through the list of objects, consult the dictionary for the categories, and then take each of these elements here and slot it to the right list of these three. So how do we do that? We need to loop through the list of objects. And we need to use something called a for loop. So if we type here for each in the activities search box, we find a for each activity. We can drag and drop it at the end. And here we have for each item in, and we have to say here in which object we want to loop. We want to loop here in the list of objects. So for each item in the list of objects, meaning for each of these elements here, we want to do something. First of all, we want to get the category. So we can use an assign. We would want to consult the dictionary and get the category. So we can have here, let's say, a temporary variable. We press Ctrl K to define a new variable. We say string underscore category. And in this string, we want to save what is the right category from the dictionary for that object. So we just have to say here dict categories, and then in brackets item, because this is the element from the list, gets the first element in the first iteration, then the second one, and so on. And we can say toString just to make sure we have a string here. So with this assign, we get in the string category variable what is the value for this key. So if we have the first element, which is in our case socks, then it will look in the dictionary and it will get for this key, for socks, the value, which is clothes drawer. So we will have here in this variable clothes drawer for the string category. And then we have to decide in which list we want to assign it. And just to make it clear, we can use something called a switch activity. So here inside the body, for each iteration, we can use as an expression the category, and we define some cases. So we can define here a case called clothes drawer. And we get an error because it apparently expects here an integer, a number, and that's because we have the type argument here as number. We have to go and change it, delete this first, go and change it to string, and then we can add here string values, so words. All right, there is our first case. And in this case, we want to add an element to the list, or the current element to the list. And we have an activity called add to collection. We can drag and drop it here. And for the collection, in this case, if we have the category clothes drawer, we want to add it to the list of clothes drawer. And the item is just item point toString. We have a typo here, item toString. We still have an error. Let's see what the error is. Yes, so we need to define here string as well as a type argument, and the error goes away. So let's define our cases in a very similar manner for bookshelf. We drag and drop add to collection, should be a string, the item is item to string, and the collection in this case is list underscore bookshelf. And then our last case should be toys box add to collection, item to string. We have a string in the type, and here we have list toys box. So this is our switch. Based on the category, we decide in which list to add our item. And because we have everything in a for each loop, it means that it will repeat this for every element in the list above, list objects defined here. And now let's list in output what are the final categories and where each element has been slotted. So we can use here a log message activity. It will be after the for loop. So right here, if we're not sure if we put it right, we can just minimize the for loop. So it's correct. We say here info, and for the message, let's give it a title first, maybe to say the clothes are. And then let's have another for each loop, because we want to loop through each of the three lists. So this time we loop through the list of clothes. And what we want to do inside, we just want to log it. So each element, we will print it in the log. And we can say here, just basically item to string. You can do the same thing for the other two lists. So we say now the books are, and then we copy the same here. We just need to change the list. So it's a list of books. And at the end, we do the same for the toys. The toys are, we copy the same for each loop. And this list should be of toys. And I think we're done. So we have the initialization section here. Then we are looping through the first list of objects. We are taking each element, checking its category based on the dictionary. And then we have three different cases and we add it to the right list. And at the end, we are just listing the values in these three lists. So let's see how it works. Let's run this. And we have here in the log, we have the clothes as socks, pants. The books are Hobbit and Winnetou. And the toys are ball, train, star, and doll. So it seems to be correct. And that was it. We have learned about lists and we have revisited the dictionaries. We have looped through the lists and we have added new elements to the lists. And your rooms are now tidier. Well, at least the virtual ones. If you like this video, please hit the like button. This tells YouTube that this video is worth sharing with others. And spread the word among your friends about what you have been learning here. Stay curious and see you next time.